Hello guys, welcome to Survival Russia.
So as you might have guessed, me and Dima is on the way up to the World War II dump site. And for you guys who do not know about this location, it is up north there that they during Soviet time spent a lot of effort, not money, but a lot of time and effort to dump a whole lot of stuff up there from the old front lines. I hope there's not only shells and all that funky stuff, right? But maybe we can find some cool boxes and maybe some printing tools or whatever. By the way, if you happen to like the channel and so on, please remember to subscribe and rate the video and all that good stuff. So see you later, guys. Me and Dimo will get out of here. Well, just like yesterday, here's also a lot of bones. Crazy. This forest here is a cow graveyard, kind of. We tucked a little survival Russia vehicle away over there. I hope the camouflage will help and nobody's gonna mess with it for the day here anyway. We're going out that way to our logging trail up there from yesterday. See? Awesome, right? We're on the logging trail. We have to head about 1.2 kilometers. Then we get the big power line trail, the utility trail or what it's called. And then another kilometer. And then we are at the railroad, and then we have to go less than four, or walk less than 4 kilometers up north, and everything should be awesome. How's the view yesterday? Asking in the comment section, of course. Lars, is it always swampy in Russia? And what can I say? Around here, it is. But it's not like the same to ask a guy in Florida or South Georgia or something if the United States only consists of swamps. Keep in mind, Russia is almost twice the size of the United States. There's a lot of different geography here. Time to look like a pair of teenagers standing here with our phones. I think our logging trail is over there. Dung dung. На лево. На лево, да. We both thought our logging trail was over there, but it's actually over there. Logging trail, awesome. Go, go, go. Wow, we already had a power line trail. That's awesome. Because days are getting shorter around here. This is of course why we scouted out the road. Or the route yesterday, and starting out early because otherwise we're gonna lose a lot of daylight. And we went a little bit too much to the left. Not a big deal, we just have to head over there 500 meters. Alright guys, I just found an X. That's pretty awesome. That's going home with me. Railroad up there. But we have a crazy swamp going out there, of course. Not so awesome. We also have some houses over there. So we have to try and make our way around this stuff here. It's good that we both have our hip waders on today. Most likely a well somewhere around here. So So we have the railroad Dima pouring water from the potatoes. See what the map here says. So that's where we were stuck last time. This is it, Dima's beloved spot. But actually today it's me who having a wet sock on the left leg. We're both wearing hip waders today, but I didn't roll mine up all the way, only to the knees. Not so good. Another kilometer and we should be there. I have a hunter up there with his dog. I'll put my money on that that dog is a West Siberian Laika. Hey, Papuise! Nice dog, huh? Yeah, Maldies. I just don't like dogs behind me.
На воинской, что ли?
Нет, дальше.
Не знаю, что там есть. Посмотрим, увидим.
All right, guys. So we should be on location. So we're on location, basically. And we have a lot of signals. Just like last time, it would be awesome to find a spot to make a little fire and stuff like that. We have a hole here. With our guesses, they've been blowing up some stuff here. I said they were here blowing up stuff like 9 years ago or something. But in this area, I doubt they found it all. But this definitely looks like a crater. Dima broke my priceless axe. Dima's fully gone. Alright guys, so my socks on my left foot is dry and we got something to eat and stuff like that. So now we're gonna start searching, see what we're gonna find. We're already on the board and we are not like 30 meters from the northbound railroad there. We're gonna search the area, see what we're gonna find. Gonna get the head cam on and see you guys. I think Dima found a mortar, yeah. That's an old mortar round. Yes. Alright guys, so now we are officially on the board. We found the old mortar round. It would be awesome to find something. Some boxes or some flares or some stuff. But let's see what we're gonna find. Also I have to say that I'm a sapper and I've been digging a lot of this stuff. So it doesn't make me immune to mishaps, of course. But don't attempt to do things like this. Leave it to professionals. We found this little guy here. And the primer, word I forgot last time, is intact. Maybe it's Soviet, must be Sovietska. I guess this is from an aeroplane and it's Soviet because I cannot see any markings on it.
Germans were really meticulous with their markings. Yeah, I can't see anything. Not that interesting either, really, but nonetheless, something. Here we have another piece of shrapnel. Maybe big mortar round or something. You can see we have some threading going on here. Let's find some cool stuff. Another shell casing. Metal, not metal, iron. I'll most likely not be able to read much from this. What this once were, I have no idea. So far, nothing really cool. We found something of a considerable size here. Whoa! Whoa! Artillery shell! Dogwood, big guy. So far we're just finding all sorts of funky stuff here, like this guy, artillery shell, the bottom of an artillery shell. Dang it, it's thick walls. Hope you can see it. It's a big guy. Here we have a part of a box for mortar shells. It'll be laying here. But let's find some boxes and some cool stuff. But dang it, there's just signals everywhere. So here we found something a little bit cool. A little bit of a keeper, you can say. This is, I'll have to see. It's not been fired, of course. So, but this is most likely a German Nemetzki. Pretty short centimeter, not centimeter, 50 millimeter. Small mortar round. Bloop. That's not that bad. See, we can clean it up a little bit in the bottom there. This is a little bit interesting. I cannot really make it out, but Dima says there's written Milano on it. I can see something, something. We'll check it out later. It's in pretty good condition. That's a nice little find. We found another funky mortar guy here. Watch, it's still a switch. Good for a garden light. Here we found part of a Russian shell. We can see here, 1939. But that is also what we are finding, stuff like this, all over, simply signals everywhere, it's crazy. That's a little bit funny, this guy here, as you can see, still has the charge in it, long straws, kind of. Here we found something funky. That is definitely a German box for, I think, what is this, mortar rounds or hand grenades. All the primers would be up here. Well, that's at least something else than just shrapnel. Still has paint on it. Here we have one of the holes where they certainly have been digging. The engineers, we're having a signal down there with something, something. See, there's been a vehicle here. They've most likely been loading stuff up. That's Kodok. Well, you can see, guys, it's a little bit of a tough place to search. Because of all this stuff here. Alright guys, so we are back at our little campsite here. Not the most of awesome finds, but it's a tough place to search. And it'll take time to find whatever is left here. for sure, but we're gonna eat something and continue the search.
All right, guys, it's the day after, it's the evening after. I didn't have the energy yesterday to edit the video and all that good stuff, because no matter how you do it, getting up to that location there is really, really tough. It was a little bit easier than last time. So yeah, but we found the location. Our findings this time was not that awesome. We've been talking about maybe we want to head up there once again, give it a little bit more time, but yeah, let's see about that. But I brought two items back with me. One of them is, of course, the axe that I found in the forest. We used it at camp, and of course the handle broke off. It's a quite old axe, and it was standing like this, handle up, underneath a big spruce. This is most likely why it's in very good shape, you can say. It's even kind of sharp still. Awesome axe. I'll put up a little photo I took of the stamp here. To me it looks like it's from 1950 something. Awesome axe. That's gonna be a restoration project for sure. And I think I'm gonna make an axe for one of you guys here at some point as well. There's soon time to sit and fiddle around in the garage and all that good stuff, but I brought another little item with me. It's this little guy here. To me it looks like a 50mm mortar round. The primer down here is intact, and I will also put up a photo of this little primer. It's very, very interesting actually, because it yeah, I've not looked at the photos yet myself because I just took them, right? But it looks like something stamped in here. Some of the stamps in the little primer there is it says Milano or something like this, just like Dima said. But there's a lot of writings on it, so pretty interesting. I'll put up photo here as well. So yeah, guys, that's it for this video. I don't know if it's an awesome video or not, but nonetheless, that's what we did, and it was an awesome trip out there, even it was relatively tough. So guys, please check the links in the description. Please consider supporting the channel, the vehicle project and all that good stuff. And until next time, get out on train, get it done, do something awesome. See you in the next video, guys. I think also I want to put in here a few closing remarks about the handling of these items. As I said out there, just leave it to the professionals. Don't attempt to fiddle around with this stuff yourself. I mean, even I've been handling a lot of this UXO stuff, right, as they are called. You never really get used to it. I mean, it can be potentially your last breathing moment, but you can say you also get a really good drift of what you can do and what you cannot do. Yeah, don't attempt to fiddle around with this stuff, and it's not a good idea. Many of you guys have asked me, oh, what about mines, what about mines? I think I said it at some point that that is actually not the worst, because very often these mines, they are not even armed or anything like that. If they were, the mechanisms are not working any longer, so yeah. Do not attempt to take such stuff apart, ever. That is dangerous. Also, do not bring such stuff with you home. This stuff here is fine, of course, because it's already deactivated, you can say. But if you bring something, if you're stupid enough to bring something home with you and you put it in room temperature and so on, things can happen. What we are having in here, the active component, let's just call it that, like that, it also can get unstable over time, and yeah, no need to mess around with this. This is, of course, completely harmless.